Breaking news tonight, live New Hampshire. A schoolgirl walks home from school, vanishes without a trace. After mommy gets a curious letter from her girl, she's found, pale, emaciated, but alive, held prisoner in this shipping container. 9 long months on the property of 34-year-old white male Nathaniel Kibbe. Investigators dismantling it find 3 separate rooms soundproofed. Bombshell tonight, inside the investigation reveals details. Shock collars, tasers, eyes duct taped shut, torture, threats. Tonight, we want justice. That. Unleashed Lawyers. Joining me, Robert Schalk out of New York, Mike Gottlieb, defense attorney out of Fort Lauderdale. All right, Gottlieb, let's start with you. Did you hear Candace Trunzo from Daily Mail?
I did hear her. I didn't hear anything about
on a schoolgirl.
I didn't read anything about a cattle prod. I heard about stun guns. It's obviously horrific. It's obviously horrific. But, you know, those are the facts of the case. They still need to be proven, Nancy. And those facts have not yet been proven.
Why should he get bond before trial? Give me one reason. One reason he should get bond.
Easy. It's because the United States Constitution says that we are innocent unless until proven guilty.
That may be true, but he should sit behind bars and be innocent, according to you. Why should he get out and walk free?
Because he is innocent until proven guilty. You have to weigh the evidence, and we have to weigh the evidence and determine whether or not there's enough evidence to incarcerate him.
My God, because, Lee, Nancy, just give me one reason why he should get out.
He should get out because he's innocent until proven guilty. Right. What's the evidence? What? Right now you have an allegation. Let's hear about DNA. Let's hear about fingerprints. Let's hear about proof. I haven't heard anything other than allegations. And that's why he should be entitled to a bond.
Could you explain, Mr. Gottlieb, why it is that there are so many people sitting in jail waiting for their trial? It's because they don't get bond.
Because
their crimes are so heinous, they can't get a bond.
Well, maybe it's because the system of justice isn't always fair, Nancy. Isn't that possible that we're wrongfully we have exonerations every single day in the United States, people who have been wrongfully convicted.
Just pages and pages and pages, 200 plus counts of charges. Will he repeat offend again? He's already done it 200 times, Gottlieb, according to police. If you don't know a horse, look at his track record. What makes you think he won't do it again?
Oftentimes, the prosecution will come out with a weighty indictment because when you look at the charges, they're so voluminous, it looks like it's hard to fight. And that's oftentimes a signal that they really don't have a lot of evidence. It's used to intimidate defendants not to take the case to trial and instead to enter into a plea bargain.
Unleash Your Lawyers, Robert Schalk and Mike Gottlieb. Gottlieb out of Fort Lauderdale, Schalk out of New York. All right, Mike Gottlieb, you have heard what a child goes through. And this schoolgirl was held for 9 months. And you still think he deserves a bond modification, that he, Nathaniel Kibbe, should walk free until he goes to trial?
Nancy, again, a bond modification is based on, you know, one of the criteria, whether or not the offender can afford the bond. The bond is set at $1 million. Then we weigh the evidence. There's evidence, there's allegations in this case that haven't yet been proven. We don't know the strengths of them. The police are holding them back. Yes, it is appropriate for the court to revisit the bond. He's innocent until proven guilty, and the prosecution and the judge needs to make an appropriate decision based on the weight of the evidence that the prosecutor can offer, if they have any.
And now live to Baytown, Texas, a registered sex offender convicted of sex assault on a 12-year-old little boy, busted, caught, red-handed, posing as Santa at the local McDonald's. The pervy Santa Claus spotted with little boys on his lap snapping photos. Now that's certainly a stocking stuffer. I think I'd rather get a lump of coal. But Robert Schalk and Mike Gottlieb, he can't work in an amusement park running a machine, but he can sit with little boys up in his lap and take photos dressed as Santa, Mike Gottlieb?
Well, clearly McDonald's or whoever he was working for should have screened him a little bit better for this job.
Their
fault. The reason the police
are you trying to say it's McDonald's fault that this guy
I'm suggesting
a perv?
That I'm suggesting they should have screened him better for the job, but the reason the police let him go was there was no evidence that he did anything wrong while in the Santa costume. There's no evidence he improperly touched any child. The question is, was Santa naughty or nice? And in this case, Santa was nice, Nancy.